I love Gmail. I'm gonna go over 10 tips that I personally use to be more productive in Gmail. In fact, I use Gmail for all my email at this point, and I like it that much. I'll tell you how I route all my email over to Gmail as well. It's not too hard, it takes a little setup, and I'm actually gonna go over 10 things, and that one's number 10, so be sure to stick around for it. I'm Doug Cunnington, I'm the founder of Niche Site Project. I talk about Amazon affiliate sites and internet marketing, productivity, that's what this is about today, is productivity, and I'm a project manager as well. So have a look around at the channel. If you like what you see, please subscribe. So let's get over to my Gmail tips right now. Tip number one is you could place periods throughout your email address. It doesn't matter. Google treats those email addresses the same. So quick example so you could see this. By the way, this tip has been around, this tactic has been around for a while. I referenced this blog post from 2008, but basically when you take a look at doug.c@gmail.com or d.ougc@gmail.com, those are equivalent, right? Google Gmail doesn't care. So why would you want to do this? Sometimes you say subscribe to an email newsletter or something and it doesn't register for some reason. And what you can do is type in your address differently. You'll still get the email, but it won't sort of triggers over on the email service provider. So it's just a way to divide things up. Number two, in a similar way, is you can add a plus sign at the end of your email account. So, you know, the example they give here is hikingfan@gmail.com, and you could send the email address to hikingfanplusfriends@gmail.com. And what that does is allows you to, you know, sign up for like a newsletter. And if you start getting more emails from the specific email account that you've listed with the plus appended on the end, you know that they sold your email to some other company. That's not the main reason though. For me, it's a great way to sort your emails. So you can label certain emails. Maybe you could file all your newsletter or internet marketing related emails to a specific label and then keep them out of your inbox. It's a nice way to filter messages and then apply a label to them in a simple way. Tip number three is keyboard shortcuts. So whatever app you're using, if you're spending a lot of time in it, you should definitely check out keyboard shortcuts. So all you have to do when you're in the app is click a question mark. So boom, you have all these keyboard shortcuts for Gmail. Some of them are kind of advanced. And if you learn your way around, you don't have to touch the mouse really. You could just do all sorts of cool stuff and never leave the keyboard. So highly recommend, I mean, I only know a few of these, but if you, I mean, you can even use a keyboard shortcut to add BCC recipients and stuff like that. Super advanced. And most of the apps out there have some sort of keyboard shortcut, like key like this. So highly encourage you to check it out. Just try and learn like one per week or something. If you could start adding those in, you can really speed things up. The next three are all using Boomerang. So Boomerang is an extension for Gmail. It has a freemium model, so you can test it out and get some decent functionality even without paying for anything. Once you do pay for it, you get, you know, full functionality. It's relatively cheap, I think under $10 per month, but super cool. So three tips around that. Number one is you can make an email like come back to your inbox. So for example, I can, you know, check out one of these emails here, and let's say I want to have it come back sometime in the future, I could just click Boomerang and return the conversation to the inbox. I can select if nobody responds, yes or no, or in a certain amount of time. So 2 hours, 4 hours, 2 days, 4 days, a week, 2 months, or you could pick whatever time you want. And why is this valuable? So a lot of times we want to clear out our inbox. It's really cool if we don't have to like make a note or remember or write it down somewhere that we need to take an action based on whether someone responds or someone doesn't respond. Also, this is not like sending automated emails or anything like that. This merely places this email back at the top of my inbox so I can look at it again. It's super cool because you could work through your inbox and say, you know, remind me about this in 4 days. And if nobody responds, I know I could follow up with the person. Super powerful, really, really cool thing you could do. Number five, another Boomerang feature is you could delay sending. So let's say I want to reply back to this email and I want to send it later. So I could send this later by however many hours I want to. So in 2 hours and 4 hours and a few days or whatever, or a specific time. So why is that effective? Well, a lot of times I'll sit down to answer emails. And if I start answering emails, I might start getting replies back. And if I'm working through, say, 20 emails in my inbox and I start getting a reply back for several of them, let's say 50%, I get a reply back. Maybe if there's a few people on the email, maybe I get a few messages back for one email. All of a sudden, I have 30 emails to answer instead of just 20. And it feels bad. It hurts when you're not making progress. And you know, the mountain you're climbing is getting taller as you're trying to climb it. It's frustrating. So what you can do instead to buy yourself some time is you could potentially send these later. So if I'm replying to the email, for example, I could say send it in 2 hours. And I know in 2 hours, I'm going to be not working. I'm starting my weekend and I could go on with my day. So if you delay everything by a couple hours, you could send those out, buy yourself some time, and you know you're not gonna have like an endless inbox. Again, that's frustrating. So number six is pausing your inbox. So this is a new feature that Boomerang came out with, and it's a pause button right here. So basically, you can stop receiving emails and you could turn on an autoresponder if you want. You can have delivery exceptions, which you have to upgrade to a pro or premium plan, but basically it will not accept any new emails. It'll just put them sort of like on the server, but they won't show up in your inbox until later when you unpause it. But if you want to have exceptions, maybe, you know, if you want to get your boss's emails, you can make sure it comes through, or any high priority stuff. Or you can bring messages into the inbox on a schedule. So that's a similar thing that you could set up in like Outlook. Back in my corporate days, I used Outlook, and basically you're able to, you know, pull the messages at a schedule, and that is effective too. But this pause feature is really nice to use. Number seven is very similar to the last one, is using Gmail offline. So this of course could be effective if you are flying or you're traveling, you don't have an internet connection for some reason, or it's also pretty cool if you, you know, you have to download a Chrome extension here, but basically you're able to work offline and you can say do some work without the distraction of actually being connected to the internet, which sounds funny to say, but you know, to the point I made before, when you start answering back emails, when you start sending emails, you'll start receiving emails and that can be distracting. So if you are working offline, you can get work done without being distracted. Again, super, you know, effective if you are traveling or you don't have an internet connection, but you could also use it as a productivity hack to just be able to get work done without getting distracted. Number eight is reply all. So you're able to, you know, make some settings changes in the, you know, the general section here. There's a few settings. This is kind of how I have things set up just in general. A lot of things are by default, but one thing I like to have is reply all. Some people may find that dangerous, but I don't have a huge number of people that I have to reply to on a regular basis. So a lot of times if, you know, emails are sent out with multiple people on the to line, everyone needs to be informed. Now, of course, it can get you into trouble. And I remember friends at work had this issue. They would hit reply all, or they would accidentally hit reply all, and then they intended for a message to go to one individual, but it went to everybody. In my line of work now, it's not a huge deal, but it's nice to have that done by default. So I have that checked. Number nine is a little bit more of a productivity thing on my end, but basically the send and archive. So the send and archive button allows you to send your reply and then it gets it out of your inbox. So we could take a look at it here. This is the send and archive button here versus the regular send button. And again, just quick callback, this is a keyboard shortcut. So it's the Apple, the command button and enter, and that'll send it. So you don't have to click the send button. You can just type your message, click Apple button and enter, and you're good to go. But the send and archive, it saves you a little bit of a step. So not a huge thing, but it's nice when you're working through an inbox, you could just click this. And then when you go back to your inbox after you replied to a bunch of messages, it's already archived. You don't have to worry about it. And number 10, as I mentioned, I route all my emails over to Gmail. It's just easier for me. So I have my own email accounts on various hosting accounts. And like I said, for me, it's just easier to have everything all together. So, you know, here's documentation on how to check emails from other accounts. Essentially, you have to put in your account information into Gmail, and Gmail will act as an email client. Now, why would we want to do that? It seems like extra work when you can just, you know, use a different email client. Well, for me, I'd rather just use everything in Gmail, and I really like the search capability and I guess just overall how well Gmail works. It took me a little while to get used to the labeling system versus folders, but now that I am used to it, I really like labels. In fact, if you're interested, let me know in the comments if you want to see how I, you know, manage projects and stuff using labels and use labels as a workflow. So I can kind of go into an example on that. Actually use that for customer support and being able to work with team members. So, you know, we don't miss anything. And it's just simple labels, very straightforward. The point is in Gmail, I feel like I have just a greater capability to, you know, search for emails, have everything in one repository. So I literally have all my other accounts going to, you know, Gmail in some fashion. Now I do have multiple Gmail accounts, so there are different areas in which I have, you know, different projects going to. So again, from a productivity standpoint, I do have different sort of silos of email accounts, but for me, it works. And the last tip, bonus tip number 11, if you don't have the mobile Gmail app, check it out. So I used to use the regular mail app on my iPhones and it was fine, but I can't remember. It wasn't working exactly how I wanted and I was just having a little trouble with Gmail. So I actually downloaded the Gmail app and they have this cool thing here where, you know, I can just show you on here, they're a little sample, but if you get asked a question or someone is inquiring something in an email, Gmail, the mobile app, will give you three options for a smart reply. So if we sort of zoom in here, you can see it's pretty good. And I'll say that I've used it quite a bit. So about 50% of the time, like one of the options that I would use is in there. Now I may have to add a couple details or a couple other notes, but it's pretty darn good most of the time. So if you are big into Gmail, definitely check out the Gmail app. I find it works way better than the regular mail app on my iPhone. I assume if you have an Android device, you already have the Gmail app on there and you're probably using it and you probably love it. So anyway, these are my tips. Let me know in the comments below if you are using any of the tips. And even more important, let me know if you have any tips for using Gmail. Last thing for you know, if you're interested in seeing how I use labels to, you know, manage projects and work through, you know, problems with my team and stuff, let me know in the comments below and I can go through, you know, a quick example on that stuff. Thanks again. And if you're still watching, it means you probably liked it. So hit the like button, please subscribe if you're not. And if you found it helpful, you know, share it with some friends. It'll be awesome. Thanks.